Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus Community College of Rhode Island.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Bristol Bayhawks Lady Basketball. I'm Craig Salvador. Beside me is David Cardoza. David Cardoza, we are here for a pretty good game right now as Community College of Rhode Island will be taking on our Bristol Bayhawks here in Bishop Colony High School. So we're getting ready for tip-off in just a couple minutes.
Yeah, glad to be here, Craig. Bristol coming in today at 2-6, 2-3 in Region 21, CCRI. They come in at 500 overall, 1-0 in Region 21. It should be a good matchup, CCRI and BCC. So we're getting ready for the tip-off, and excited to be here.
We saw last game against Massasoit. We saw this team. It was a tough game for the Bayhawks for anyone who wasn't named Megan Parrish, as she was really the only contributor, contributing over 20 points throughout the game.
Yeah, Megan Parrish just lit. I mean, since you and I have been calling the games here, Craig, she's just been lighting it up. So definitely expecting a big game for her. It seems like she progressively just gets more and more aggressive. Like, she takes it right at people.
And after we go. Bayhawks ball. Losing it already. Megan Parrish will be recovering. Nope, she doesn't get it. Tripped, lost the ball.
No call there. She just fell.
Yep. Right now that is Kelsey Hernandez with the ball right now. She's passing it over to Teandra Hans, back to Hernandez. In the corner for three, that is Deaza Allen. So Allen with three, quickly right out of the gate. This one gets lost already. It's recovered quickly by Rhode Island.
That was a nice shot there by number 15, Deja Allen.
Yep.
Great rotation on that ball.
And Hans passed it over into the corner, up and over to the paint. That is Deanna Jackson losing it quickly. Here's Edwards going down the court.
Good defensive play by Edwards.
Edwards charging it, puts it up, unable to get it in. Hands charging up, laying it up, just out. Megan Parrish trying to recover, but she can't get it. Now she does have it. That was a.
Seems like the girls just can't get off the floor here.
Well, that was an interesting play right there. It looked like she tried to pass it and just nicked it on something. Parrish was able to get it.
BCC needs to put more pressure on teams. It seems like they just lay back on defense. I'd like to see them press more and be more aggressive on defense. Seems like that's something that they're lacking.
Yeah, definitely. Now Hans with a long pass over into the corner. Good game of keep around. Throwing it up, and that's one's good for two.
Like, where is the – you got to stop the ball. Where is the person getting into her face? They're letting the other teams attack them. Not a good look early. You're down five.
Yeah, right now the Bayhawks, they're just throwing it around – or getting it thrown around them. But Megan Parrish with a nice layup in the paint for two.
Well, here's a continuation of the Megan Parrish show.
Now Hernandez bringing it down, passing over to Hans. And that one's banked in for an easy two. We're seeing good passing game from Rhode Island right now.
And they're working it inside, and they got no one. There's no one that's stepping it up down in the post on defense for BCC.
All right, now Edwards going up, and she's going to get steps called on her. So this is going to be Rhode Island's ball. But right now, the Bayhawks aren't playing a lot of aggressive defense right now. They're letting Rhode Island just kind of walk all over them, pass around them very easily.
Yeah, not a good start for BCC.
Hernandez up and over to their center. There's Hans over in the corner. Up and almost for three. Gets recovered.
Was that Deja Allen that shot that?
I believe it was.
It looks like she's not afraid to shoot, so I expect she's going to get a lot of looks like that today. It looks like she's their shooter, so.
Yep. Parrish and Edwards still having that good chemistry. I remember last game, they were the only two really scoring for the team. This one almost rolls out of bounds, but it gets saved. This one's good for
there
two.
It goes.
That is Shannon Rosensteel right there. Now it's a three-point game.
Nice shot there by Rosensteel from the elbow. Someone else needs to step up for BCC.
Yeah, definitely right now. It looks like they were calling a foul on number 30. That was Megan Parrish. And there'll be no shot, and this one's going to get thrown in. See, just good passing game right here. Just quick in and out, able to get to the open person.
Definitely. BCC in its zone right now.
22, Mackenzie Brayman.
See, nobody in her face. Put a hand up. Put your hands up on defense.
Now, right now, just not able to get a good shot. Edwards, that one gets away. Edward takes it. Throwing it. They're calling that foul on Tiandra Hands. And it'll be no shot. This one's going to get thrown in by Katya Luna.
BCC creeping back in here. It's a 7-4 lead now.
A long throw, risky throw, and it doesn't pay off as Hands able to grab that one. You know, yeah, with a name like Hands, you got to have a good grab game like that. Risky bounce pass, but it pays off.
I like the way they work it inside, they work it outside, they pass the ball around the perimeter.
Yep.
Wow.
This one just off the rim and in. That is Deanna Jackson right there.
I look for her to be a beast today, Craig. She looks like she's getting position in there and she's working it. And she's gonna get a lot of shots down inside today, I think.
Speaking of a lot of shots, Megan Parrish had the ball. Giving it over to Edwards. Back to Parrish. She's rushing down to the key. This one almost lost it. Able to recover is Luna. Throw over to Parrish. Over to Edwards. Edwards with a slow charge. Able to get it. But just overshot. Taken by Rhode Island.
Not a good offensive possession there, Craig. Not an awful possession.
No, that was Deja again, but just missing.
They get a 3-on-1 here. They got to execute, and they do.
Nice layup by Shannon Rosensteel right there. And Hernandez quickly coming back down with it.
And Rosensteel with 4 points here, 4 out of 6 for BCC.
Definitely showing her skills, and they called steps right there on Hernandez. So Megan Parrish will be the one to throw it in for the Bayhawks.
And Craig, in our games together that we've called Lady Bayhawk basketball, it seems like the game just gets away from them after the first quarter or two, and next thing you know, it's a blowout. Hopefully they can stay into this game until the end so we can stay awake during this one.
Yeah, that is true, Dave. But what we've seen is because the Bayhawks, they don't have much of a bench. Right now you can see it's only Katya Luna over there sitting on the bench, the only Lady Bayhawk on the bench right now. So definitely getting fatigued. But doesn't look like Rhode Island has that big of a bench. They have 3 subs, though, so that's definitely going to help them.
Three is better than one.
Exactly. Again with this
look
passing
at the way
game.
They work it inside, and they count it.
It's a beautiful shot right there, beautiful movement. Deanna Jackson in the paint for 2. They're calling that foul on Asia Contractor, so Jackson's going to the line. It's good for the first foul shot of this game by anybody.
Well, Deanna Jackson completes the old-fashioned three-point play, and she's listed as a 4, but she's definitely their center.
Well, it's good to have people who can play multiple positions like that.
And the Bayhawks turn the ball over again there. I was talking to Coach Aaron Morrell after last week's game, Craig, and he said that the reason his bench is decimated like that because he had a few girls with just some discipline issues, so he kind of. He did what he had to do, you know, to cut some of the bad seeds out there. Unfortunate for him, he only has 6 players.
Rosensteel again with a nice layup. Been doing pretty good with that so far this game.
Rosensteel get up to a hot start here. She can contribute the way that she can. Bayhawks can keep it close.
Edwards with the steal. She's dribbling, hustling down the court. Rosensteel wide open again. Little almost
that's
lost possession.
That's a nice,
possession,
pay. That's a nice pass.
Right
nice play.
Rosensteel doing it again.
Nice pass by Edwards, though.
Edwards has been getting some good steals, some nice passing right there, and Rosensteel doing a great job just getting wide open for the easy layups.
If Edwards can keep her, I mean, if she can keep her head in the game, I mean, she's a good offensive player. And she's good on the defensive end, too. She's got good hands. You know, she's I expect big things out of her. She can just keep her head in the game and – you know, she's an emotional player. She can just, you know, just not think about the BS and just play her game. And be an inspiration to her team, she can help catapult this team to some wins here.
Exactly. You can remember from the last game we called, when Megan Parrish wasn't going off, it was Edwards who was going off.
That's right. So
she was a big contributor last game, and she's looking to be a big contributor this game.
I know she's got it in her. She's feisty, but she's got to channel that. She's got to channel that anger and channel that energy into the into her team instead of worrying about the refs and worrying about all the other extracurricular stuff. Nice drive there.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Mackenzie Brayman with the layup drive, good for two. So Parrish coming back down, very methodically dribbling as she gives it to Rosensteel. Rosensteel to Edwards now.
Edwards getting aggressive, and that's what you want to see from her.
And she will go to the line. And that is a foul on number 20. That is Deanna Jackson right there. That is her first of the game, second team foul.
So we've seen Rosensteel get on the action. She has 8 points. Megan Parrish only has two. But Megan Parrish is such a... She's such an unselfish player. Like, she's a very good offensive player. You know that she can score and that she can score a lot of points. But she wants to get her team involved, too. So, you know.
Yeah, exactly. The second foul shot's good. Yeah. So, it brings it to a three-point game as Hernandez bringing down the court.
Oh, what a nice pass.
Just can't connect, but she got the offensive rebound on that.
That was hands, right, with that pass?
That was hands with the pass, and that was Deanna Jackson under the hoop getting that.
Good quick pass, like a nice touch pass there.
That's something we've seen from Rhode Island early on in this game, is they're very quick to get rid of the ball, and that's good right now. Gets the defense moving, gets them tired, and you can take a quick shot when an open person.
Definitely unselfish. Ooh, that was a quick release there. Rebound by Edwards.
She's going down. Up, oh, Rosensteel with the rebound. She's going back. Parrish wide open, giving it to her.
We talk about aggressiveness. It seems like BCC has really stepped up their game. They were down. They were down early. They looked like they were asleep, and right now they're only trailing by three with 3 minutes to play in the quarter.
Parrish now just trying to find someone open. That one gets away from Rosensteel. This is Van Bemelen coming in. She gets that one in for two.
If you're going to foul her, I think you need a fouler guard. Give her a little bump.
They're calling that on the
foul her like you mean it.
Calling that one on Megan Parrish, and that's her second.
I think if you're Coach Amarell, I take Megan Parrish out here. I know you only have six players, but you have Lunar on the bench. I would take Megan Parrish out here near the end of the first quarter.
Luna's been sitting for quite a while, so when you have a bench like that, do you think, Dave, do you think quick subs would help out? Just really try to keep at least one person fresh the whole time?
Yeah.
Just keep subbing that one person. And they're calling steps on that one on 33, Adia Contractor.
Actually, Craig, they call it a double dribble. You gave the double dribble sign, so she put both hands on the ball.
Sorry, I missed that.
Something of the like.
Nice pass right there, but quickly lost. And over Paris's head.
Ooh.
Almost saved it, but just couldn't.
Love the way Rhode Island passes the ball. They're just not passing around the perimeter. They're looking to pound it inside, too. They're always looking for the open person. They're moving that zone around. And BCC's zone is kind of slow right now. Slow to the basketball.
Well, definitely right now, they're just still just working easily around her.
Oh, looks like it's going BCC's way. Missed the call. Not too many fouls in this first quarter, Craig.
No, only two by the Knights, three by the Bayhawks. This one up and over. Edwards able to get that one over to Rosensteel, but gets quickly shot away.
Got to get back on defense. Got to get back on defense.
Allen with a nice pass, but unable to She almost dropped it, but she gets it back, able to put it in for two.
Well, Coach Amarell calls a timeout here, Craig. 19-11, minute 50 here in the first quarter. Bayhawks in it, but you know what happens. They stay in it for the first quarter. The next thing you know, the pattern seems to be is the other team's lead seems to extend and extend little by little. Next thing you know, you're down 20.
Yeah, exactly, especially with the way Rhode Island's offense has been going, really just the quick passes able to get around the defense. That tires them out really quickly, and the Bayhawks, they can't afford to get tired with the lack of subs they have.
That's the truth. You know, I'm not sure how you do it if you're Coach Amarell. I think you can't just leave five guys, you can't leave five girls in all the time. I think you got to kind of, you know, use that one sub effectively. There's a way to get, you know, a few girls at least rest.
Exactly. This one for three, but it's airballed.
She definitely had open shot.
Allen was able to pick it up. There goes Hands now over to Allen. Over in the corner, pops it up. This one's good for three.
Wow.
In the splash zone right there.
Wow, Craig. I feel like that open three is going to be open all day for CCRI.
They've been showing that all game. Rosensteel now almost doing what she does best. Shot from the paint, just unable to get it. Can't make every shot. Allen in the corner again. And looks like they're going to be calling a foul on that. Looks like she's going to be going to the line.
CCRI Knights, they look like they can do whatever they want to do offensively. The way that they move the ball, the way that they get the ball inside.
And this one's going to get thrown in, not to the line. And we see Katya Luna coming in for Megan Parrish now. Parrish had three fouls so far.
See, that three is just open. Got to get in her face.
Luna just in the game gets the defensive rebound right there. Edwards, Rose
nice
still
pass
has
by
it.
Edwards.
Just missed. And that is a foul right there on, I believe that was De'Asia Allen. So Deborah Banks is going to be going to the line for the first time this game.
Good pass by Edwards there, Craig. She's a good passer. Just people, you know, her teammates is not connecting on a couple of them.
Her and Rosensteel, they got that good connection that they've been showing this game, but sometimes it just isn't always working. So Banks, after missing the first free throw, able to sink the second one.
That's a big free throw there. Anytime you can see some points go on the board.
And this one in for two with 25 seconds remaining.
You hear Coach Adam Morell say that's too easy. They're getting easy baskets, easy buckets.
Yep, just driving into the paint, getting for two. Luna loses this one to Allen, but they're going to call a travel on that. This one's going back to Bristol with 11.2 seconds remaining. The Knights have doubled the score of the Bayhawks right here in the first quarter.
If you're BCC, you gotta stay around in this game. That's a push. That's an obvious push there by Edwards, pushing off.
And this looks like it's just going to run out the time.
That's like an offensive interference. If this were football, you can't just let the time run out the clock like that.
Nope, this isn't football. Can't have that happen.
This isn't football or like, I remember playing youth basketball. Sometimes they would just like. Let the clock run the whole time.
Nope, so it's going back to 11 seconds. And now the clock's not even running down. There it goes.
See, that shot. She had that shot.
Allen puts up for three. I'm able to get it. Edwards rebounds it. 2 seconds left. She's going to have to do something. Puts it up at the buzzer. It's no good.
Nice try there by Misa Edwards. That would have counted if it went. She went the length of the court. Great effort. But couldn't get it to drop.
Right there at the end of the first quarter now, Knights have 24. The Bayhawks, they have 12 right now.
Not an insurmountable lead by any point, by any stretch of the imagination, but in talking to Coach Morell, the morale of the team seems to just drop every time they're down. There's no sense of fight. They gotta fight. Gotta get a couple baskets here at the beginning of the second quarter. Get it underneath 10, and get yourself some hope. Because if CCRI comes out and hits a three, gets a couple baskets, BCC is going to be demoralized, and it's going to be right back to where they were.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, down, losing by 20 or 30 points, and you can't have that. It's a consistent pattern.
Yeah, exactly. Right now, BCC's real problem right now is their defense, is they just can't shut down the Knights as they're walking all over them, able to drive into the paint, taking wide open threes, just doing it all to get around them.
Well, the thing is, Craig, when you only have five or six players, you're almost like scared to foul. Like if when you have 10 players and you have a rotation, you got girls that can sub in and out, then you can play defense the way you want to, and you're not scared to foul or commit these little knick-knack fouls. But when you don't have enough players to sub in, you're almost scared to get the fouls because you could be down to playing three players on the court come the fourth quarter. You got no fouls to give, you know?
Yeah, exactly. At the end of that first quarter, Megan Parrish had three, and she's been their best player last game at least. Definitely not having her and then just being reserved only five players, that's a huge hit right there.
Right.
For BCC. And again, Megan Parrish, who dropped 20 points the last game, you don't want her out of this game.
That's true, but I mean.
Foul!
What are you doing?
They're just going to hang on with it. 10 seconds left. Just passing around.
You have to foul!
It doesn't
look
like
they will. What are you doing?
3, 2, 1, and that is the game.
What are you doing?
Just an
what
absolute.
What in the hell just happened?
Just an absolutely horrible last break right there
what
for the Bayhawks.
What a horrible last 30 seconds.
Chance to make it a three-point game. Three-pointer to tie it, send it in overtime. That is just.
You just let them run the last 25 seconds off the clock and didn't even give yourself a chance to do anything there. I'm flabbergasted.
That's just disappointing right there. They're definitely probably going to get a talking to from their coach after this game.
Well, I think it was a big gap there. So 69-65, obviously a great effort here by the Lady Bayhawks, Craig. So we're going to wrap it up. You want to give our Lady Bayhawks player of the game, probably Shannon Rosensteel.
Yeah, definitely Shannon Rosensteel. She was able to do it all from scoring points to getting rebounds, making good shots, just doing it all. So the final score, 69-65 in favor of the Community College of Rhode Island Warriors. For Bayhawks basketball and FR Media, I'm Craig Salvador. And for Dave Cardozo, wish you a good night, and we'll see you on Saturday.
Good night, everybody. Yeah, if you're Coach Aaron Morrell at the half, I mean, you're telling your girls you're still in this thing. Like, you could be way out of this thing, and you're 43-30. You come out in the second half, and they're just going to call this half three tenths of a second on there, and they're just going to call the half, and I can see why.
Yep. So at the end of the first half, 43-30 in favor of the Knights right now. We'll see you soon.
See you soon.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We are back. I'm Craig Salvador. Beside me is David Cardoza. And Dave, we are back here in the third quarter now with the Knights up 43-30. Give us a brief rundown of what happened in the first half.
Well, the Lady Bayhawks, they fell down early to CCRI. And they worked their way back in. They made a little run of it. They were trailing it by as much as 17. They cut it down to within 10. It's now a 13-point lead. I'm looking for the Lady Bayhawks to really come out and be aggressive. And there you go to Rosensteel. Nice pass by Parrish there.
Yeah, we saw Rosensteel get hot early in this game, and she's off to a quick start, just like in the first half. Definitely when we want to see a great pass and a great steal by Megan Parrish. Deion Jackson looking to put up a shot, but gives it over to Hernandez.
Yeah, I thought BCC really looked lackadaisical on defense and not aggressive enough, and now they're coming out aggressive.
That one's going to stay over for Rhode Island, but a great attempt by Megan Parrish right there, almost getting her second steal in just seconds in the game.
Good to see BCC finally wake up. Looked like they played most of the first half asleep, especially on the defensive end, allowing a lot of easy buckets for the for CCRI, and CCRI was able to get a lot of looks, especially from the outside.
Something I've noticed already right now is they're trying to stop those three-pointer shots, because we saw in the first half they were just leaving them wide open now. So you can take that out of the factor that's going to play a big role right now in this game.
Yeah, no more open looks. Like, Kelsey Hernandez was able to, like, weave her way through the defense, and it was able to find Deanna Jackson, was able to get her own shots. And
you see De'Asia Allen getting open looks left and right, putting up threes.
Yeah, all of that.
Speaking of Allen, she has the ball going over to Hernandez.
Nice entry pass there by Hernandez into Jackson. She missed the bunny, though.
Hands with a nice two off the glass.
When you look at CCRI, it's really only been a tale of a few girls. Tiana Hands has contributed, Kelsey Hernandez, a leading scorer, and then Jackson. Everybody else has kind of been non-existent.
Rose is still one of the two. We've seen Allen put up a couple threes before, but again, it's really Kelsey Hernandez, I say, has been the best player, that and Jackson. And Hands now with the layup for two.
Wow, nice bounce pass there by Hernandez. And now just like that, it's back up to 15, Craig. Not what Coach Amarell wanted. 47-32 now. Again, the effort and the spirit was there by BCC to open up this quarter, but they find themselves down by 15.
Yeah, you're right, Dave. It looked like just out of the gate, it looked like the Bayhawks were going to be playing some good defense right there, getting up quick steals and quick points. But quickly now, just first 2 minutes, going back to Rhode Island.
If you're BCC, you got to slow down the tempo of the Knights. Stop them from fast breaking. Stop them from driving to the hole. Like I said, don't be afraid to foul. Be aggressive. Stay up on them.
Right now, the Bayhawks ball. Megan Parrish will be taking it down. Over to Luna. Misha Edwards driving up for two, and that one able to fall in.
That's a big shot there. Because you get down by 15 quick here in the third quarter. That kind of stops the bleeding a little bit.
They're calling a travel right there on Hands.
And that's a big turnover.
Yep, with a name like Hands, you're definitely not known for your feet.
Oh, man. I think if I'm Megan Parrish now I'm gonna try to, take over this game.
Yeah, I was kind of surprised Rosensteel didn't. This one's good for three right there by Luna. She makes the three now. Sorry, take a couple tries in the first, but wasn't able to make it, making that one.
That's for sure, Craig. We talked about it. We said that she needs to see one drop. She's continued to shoot. She finally gets one to drop. That was huge for Luna.
Yeah, bringing in the 10 now. Allen not able to get this one. Banks able to get this, able to bring this one down. Parrish now with fire in her eyes. She's driving. She has no regard for human life. She gets the and one,
too. I told you she's got no fear. She'll take it right at you. And just like that, we talked about it being a 15-point deficit. Now it's down to 8.
And she has a pants to make it 7. I think I said pants, but I meant chance. That one hung up for a little
Megan
bit, but not able to get it.
Couldn't get it to fall. That would have cut it down to 7.
Hernandez with a good dribble game. Hands flying in, trying to get the 2. Rosenstiel brings it down. Parrish steals it. Edwin's driving, thought about putting it up, and puts this one up.
I like it. I like it. If you're BCC, you got to be aggressive taking the ball to the basket, too, because, you know, you're going to get to the free throw line.
Yeah, exactly. Something they've been doing well now is drawing fouls.
A nice pass by Parrish to get it across court to Edwards. And Edwards with a great dribble drive there. She'll step to the line for 2. And she's been doing well from the line.
Nice. Something about Megan Parrish right now. She's been playing pretty good defense recently.
She has. And, you know, I look at this team and talking to Coach Amorell, he said, you got to remember, these girls are all freshmen. They're just beginning their college career. And even though they're all freshmen, I look at Misa Edwards and I look at Megan Parrish. I look at these two as the leaders, as the leaders of this team, both in the backcourt. Down by 6 now, just like that. A 9-0 run. 9-0 run, Craig. It was 47-32.
Yeah,
good defensive play by Banks, knocking it away.
Good job keeping it in, though, by Deanna Jackson. Up and over. Hernandez had it. Looked like it was going to sail overhead, but she easily has it. In the corner now for 3, and it's good.
Wow, that's a big shot there. That's a big shot there for CCRI. It was a 9-0 run.
Looks like they're only calling that one a 2.
Well, that's huge.
That makes a big difference. Rosenstiel almost bobbled it, but she has it. Doesn't have a shot, but she puts it up anyway, and she still sinks it. Up and over everybody.
She almost lost the basketball. I like the way that she just snatched it away from the CCRI defender and then puts it up and gets it to drop in.
Yeah, great recovery.
Yeah, I like the way that she stuck with it there.
She's been going off this game. Oh, Allen up for 3, missed that one. Saw her make her first few threes, but she's been missing. Very inconsistent now this game.
Got to take the ball middle.
Calling a travel. Kind of surprised she didn't pass it back to Parrish. She was wide open there.
Yeah, I just think that she was kind of stuck in between a thought there. I think she just should have went aggressively towards the middle of the paint. Got to take the ball middle there.
Here's a drive up from the paint. Nothing.
I like the way the Bayhawks are jumping out at the three-point line now, putting their hand up. They're not letting the wide-open looks come as easily as they were before.
Yeah, right now the Bayhawks just kind of trying to get their footing. Up and over Rosenstiel. This one gets stolen. Just really caught napping. Just a really lazy pass, and that gets taken away. Big pass over the head of Deanna Jackson.
Well, you say that, Craig, and just like that, CCRI, with kind of a lackadaisical offensive possession there, throwing that one out of bounds.
Yeah, we were talking about them not making very many mistakes early on in the game, but they've definitely made a few now.
Yeah, and right now it's a 6-point game. It's anyone's game right now.
Yep.
If you're the Bayhawks, you've got to keep charging.
Edwards up for 3, not able to get it.
Maybe not quite the shot she wanted. It was kind of contested, but Misa Edwards has stepped up big time in this game.
Yep. Remember, don't sleep on the Bayhawks, because we've seen them come back now in this game. Only down by 6 points. And at one point in this game, they were down by, I think the biggest lead was probably around 15-19.
The biggest lead of the game was around 17. That's when it was like a make or break game where this game could have went south really quick for the Bayhawks, and the Bayhawks managed to keep it close at the end of the first half, and now they managed to come out in this half and cut a 15-point lead to 6. First few minutes of this half, Craig, this game looked like it was going to get out of hand again, and you got to give it to the Lady Bayhawks. They fought, scratched.
Definitely showing heart in this game. Hernandez missed her first shot. She's looking to make this a 7-point lead with her second.
Yeah, they definitely showed heart, Craig. You're right. With only 6 players, you're down by 17, you come back. You're down by 15, you come back.
She misses her second one. Looking to get her own rebound, though. She does.
Very quick to the basketball. But the
really just trying to get that one away from Banks, but the Bayhawks are going to get the call. BCC's ball now.
This will be a huge come from behind win, a win that could probably catapult a team. Don't want to count the chickens before they hatch.
No, definitely, this will be a big comeback for them. Not sure what just happened. Looked like a foul, I guess. Didn't notice it.
They're going to call a foul on number 22 there. That's
Mackenzie Brayman.
First time we've heard that name all game.
We said before, it's like a core 3 or
sophomore
4.
Sophomore guard.
Up and down right there for Contractor.
I thought she had her hand on the ball. I thought the nice defender had her hand to the ball. I thought it might have been a jump ball, but they call steps on her. Yep.
Hernandez just looking for an open look. Brayman passes it over to Allen. Up for 3, makes it. Now it's an 8-point game with
good
4
pass
remaining this quarter.
Good job by the Knights to swing it. And then that was number 12 there with the three-pointer, Ashley Van Mellen for 3.
It's over. Banks from the key, not able to get it.
Probably not her shot.
No, we haven't seen Banks with a lot of deep shots, or relatively deep shots, usually in under the paint table to make their points.
And there's Hernandez. It's a good timeout here by Aaron Morell. It was a 6-point lead, and just like that, Craig, it's back up by 11.
Yeah, 3:27 left in this quarter.
Good job by CCRI to kind of fend off the Knights, who were charging. They had a 9-0 run at one point. They cut it down to within 6. Good possession on the last possession there. They're always looking to pass. I mean, they're always trying to find the open gal, and they do it a lot of the time. Good execution there. Kelsey Hernandez is so quick. Her and Tiandra Hands are such quick little players.
Yeah, they definitely got good handles on the ball, dribbling pretty much just as well with the left hand as they are with the right, and that's very important in basketball, being able to dribble from both sides like that, drive from either side.
Yeah, and they're both tenacious. I mean, they're both tenacious and fearless with the basketball. As tiny as they are, they have a lot of heart.
And the tiny ones are the feistiest.
That's for sure. We have a feisty one of our own, I think, in Misa Edwards.
Misa Edwards, definitely, she's showing probably the most heart right now for anyone on the Bayhawks. And at first, at the very beginning of this game, it looked like Rosensteel was going to be the Bayhawks player of the game, but Edwards definitely in that talk too. And Megan Parrish has been going off again this quarter. After a quiet first half, she's starting to show her true skill in the second. Parrish will be taking it down.
54-43.
Is over Parrish in the corner. Long throw over Luna from downtown, and it's air ball just off the net. You know, they say nothing but net, but that's definitely not the kind they want.
Yeah, that was just such a deep three. I mean, that looked like she thought she was Klay Thompson out there or Steph Curry. I think that was even out of her range a little bit.
Now you see that quick release, but not a very strong release. This one up for 3 off the rim. Parrish with a rebound.
Nice rebound by Parrish up high to get it.
And they're calling a foul right there. So
they're going to call a foul. They're going to call it on Kelsey. They're going to call it on Hernandez. And she's going to come out of the game right now. Number 24, Mercedes Faust, the guard, freshman guard, is going to come in for the women of CCRI.
Well, that's a good call taking her out. She has four fouls. She's been too important for them for her to foul out right now.
Got to finish this, the third quarter strong if you're BCC.
Down by 11 with 2:40 left in the quarter. Edwards throwing the body. Megan Parrish in the corner. Lofty overshot, but Rosensteel with the rebound
good
in
job.
For two.
Way to be there. Way to be there by Rosensteel. Cuts it to within nine. Grabs the air ball out of the sky by Parrish. I mean, by Parrish. Good job to go back up and connect with that one.
That's just good court awareness right now from Rosensteel, just knowing exactly where to go, being able to put it up.
I tell you, she's been all over the place today.
Like you said, in the most affectionate way, she's been a beast.
And the Lady Bayhawk of the night.
Hands made the first one, looking to make the second one. And she's not going to. Seems like everybody from the Knights, they've been averaging about half of their foul shots.
That's for sure.
Edwards for three, just over. Banks recovers, but just not able to get it.
Banks was there. She gets a position for the rebound and the putback, but couldn't get it to go.
Hands with a nice layup for two.
So quick.
It looks like she's going one way, quickly goes the other way, and just able to sink it in. Oh, that was not a good pass. Saved, though. Luna, we usually see, is quick to put up the shot, but she hesitated way too long on that one and ended up just giving a bad pass.
The thing is, every time she gets the ball, she's looking to shoot. I mean, you get it. You don't have to shoot three all the time. You can come in, you can take the ball in.
Parrish
going in kind of wild. Couldn't get it to fall. Wow.
You've seen hands with that move a lot, just bringing it down, putting it back up, getting away from the defenders.
Great handle and great body control there on that, and that open court fast break points there by Kelsey Hernandez. Great job to kind of double pump it to avoid the defender, and still had the body control to put that one off softly off the glass and in. Shows why she's a leading scorer for CCRI. And just like that, Craig, I'm not sure if BCC can keep coming back to make this a game, because now they find themselves back down by 14. They've shown the ability to claw back before. They are making it, you know, they're definitely making it entertaining. They're making it a game here. But how many times can you keep coming back with the short bench that they have?
Not too many, but they can do it. And they can get a few breaks, again, rely on CCRI, maybe make a couple more mistakes. They can be right back in it.
And I talked before, Craig, and I was saying at the beginning of the game that BCC needed to be more aggressive, perhaps even press and trap more. But you're kind of limited in doing that because you only have six players. And when you start pressing like that, full court and trapping, then you're going to get more tired. So I guess you're kind of limited. I guess Coach Aaron Morell is kind of limited what he can do as far as that's concerned. Or maybe he feels he doesn't have the type of personnel to be able to do that.
Yeah, definitely. Bayhawks maybe, again, just playing too much hero ball right now.
And they don't need to do that. 59-45, you had them.
Ooh. Just off of Edwards going out of bounds. She was wide open on that, too.
Yeah, the ball was deflected. Looked like the ball was deflected by number 24, Mercedes Falls, but it went off of Tisha Edwards. Yeah, Tisha Edwards.
For 12. Oh,
wow.
Interesting shot, but it's good.
Ashley Van Mellen on the drive puts it up off the glass and in for the Knights. And it's a 60-point lead now. Yep. Can't get demoralized if you're BCC.
Nope. Banks the throw over everyone to Edwards. Edwards looking to charge and just throws into no man's land.
Luckily for the Bayhawks, it's going to stay right here. That pass goes off a Knights player.
Didn't get to see who it was. It was just a sea of bodies. Parrish from the corner. In for
wow,
three.
That's huge.
Swish. Nothing Parrish. But net. Hands now with the pass back up. Now the Knights with a three of her own.
Wow.
That is number 12, Ashley Van Bemelen. Rosensteel up with a two, and it's
wow.
good for the and one. Rosensteel
wow.
showing her skills again.
Wow. How about that? How about those last two trips down the floor? Megan Parrish in the corner for three. Kind of saves the Bayhawks with that three-pointer to bring it back within 13. You go back the other way, and Ashley Van Mellon hits a three on the other end.
After Rosensteel misses it, Deborah Banks get the rebound, and she gets fouled, so now she's going to the line.
And you have the ability to cut the lead to with even more.
Well, she can make these two. It's going to cut it down to only 12 with 22 left in this quarter.
Nice
she
shot.
Sinks the first one.
Calmly sinking that one.
We don't really know Deborah Banks as a shooter, so we'll see if she can make her second one.
Can't get the second one to go. Nice attempt. 13-point game, though. Still not over. Still
yep.
not. Still a lot of time left to go in this game.
Yep, Hans was taking her time. Gives it over to Van Bemelen. Over to Allen. No shot clock.
Nice to play, by Parrish. Nice hustle. She gets the basketball.
Only got one
Good
second
job.
Left.
Good defensive stand there by BCC. Coach Amarell likes it. Good job there.
Going into the last quarter. This is a 13-point game.
If you're Coach Amarell, you got to be proud of your team. You're still in this game. Again. They've seen themselves fall behind by more than double figures several times, but they've continued to hang right in there. And I think that's all we've asked for. I think that's all these fans have asked for. I think that's all Coach Amarell and his team has asked for. I think that's all of us have asked for here at FR Media as a broadcast team has asked for. So it's not a snooze fest. For the love of God.
Well, something we were talking about, I think we heard Coach Amarell say a lot of times they would get disheartened if they make too many mistakes, so that would really affect their play. But right now they're just really staying in it, keeping their heads up,
staying
calm. They
fought to stay in it, yes. Yeah, talking to Coach Amarell, he said they get disheartened, but if they fall behind by more than double figures early, and things would just kind of snowball from there. But they've had the ability and they've had the fight to stay relatively close in this one, 64-51. You know, a game could change so quickly. You come out, you get a couple steals, get a couple quick layups. Next thing you know, you're down by 10, you're down by 9, something like that. So you have a whole fourth quarter left to play. But they get to play like this is the last fourth quarter of their lives right here because, there's a little margin for error.
Oh, shit. Drop something.
Phone's here. My wallet's still here. My keys are here. I'm not sure what dropped.
I got all my stuff on me. My phone's on the table.
Something dropped.
Hopefully.
Maybe my gum. I'm not sure.
Hopefully it'll be the Bayhawks dropping points in this last quarter.
Inane banter.
They're calling travel on that one on Allen. So this is what I was talking about. They need to get fast breaks, make the team make mistakes.
Would I be a homer broadcaster if I got a Let's Go Bayhawks chant going?
You get the crowd involved.
Yeah.
Oh, Edwards in the corner for three. Just missing, but this one is rebounded. Up
Good
by
job.
Banks. Banks banks it in. Actually, that is Luna, my mistake.
Good job by Kasia Luna to be there for the rebound. Put it up off the glass and in. Had a little up fake there and put it up off the glass. That was a good job by her.
Now the crowd with a defense chant going on. Deanna Jackson has it. And they're going to call a foul that one on Deborah Banks.
Jackson just has the ability to get to the line. Well, Craig, we have the men's BCC basketball team in attendance. Looks like they're going to probably be practicing after this. Coach Rob Del Lu and his team is here in attendance, getting ready for their practice. No game for the men's team today. But the men's team doing a good job. They won their last game here at Bishop Connolly High School at their home game on last Thursday against Massasoya. And it was a big win for them.
Yep, and we'll see them on Saturday as both the Lady Bayhawks and the men's
Bayhawks. We will, and we'll both be here.
They'll both be here starting at 1 o'clock.
That's right. Amped.
Definitely going to be a good game. Here's Hans giving this one away. Lost that one, able to pick it up real quick.
Good defense.
Nice job by Luna.
Good job by
Luna
to get a hand to pass the lane.
That is huge right there. Long throw over, but Edwards, the shorter of the two, but she comes up with it. Now Parrish for three, just off the tip of the rim.
Those are probably the worst two plays I see Megan Parrish make in this young season. First of all, that cross-court pass, I'm not sure what she was trying to do with that pass there, and then she gets the ball there at the top of the key. Questionable shot. Like I said, you're working your way back into this game. A shot like that could end this game.
Exactly. This one for three, up and over. Allen with the rebound. Misha Edwards looking for the steal as this one rolls away. It's picked up by Rhode Island. Hands catching that one. Looks like she took it in the face, but she still hangs on. Now you're talking the men's team are getting into this game.
Yeah. Trying to root their ladies on.
Went over Parrish looking in the corner. This one's going to be for two. Oh, and she sinks that one in. Only a two-pointer, but still big.
Megan for three. And I could not make a Parrish with that last shot that she took. She definitely made up for it there, and I give her all the credit in the world with that having the confidence to shoot that shot.
I have no idea what she was going for with that, as Rosensteel was trying to block it, but it got away as Jackson picked it up.
You got to get on her.
Hands for three. Haven't really seen her take that many shots like that, but she's missing that one, so maybe there's a reason for that.
Parrish with the rebound, and then she gets fouled. She gets fouled by 24, Mercedes Foss, looks like.
She can bring this within eight with 7:45 left in this game. But it doesn't look like she's going to go to the line.
She's not going to the free throw line. We're still, both teams have foul each.
Well, Mercedes coming out. She has four on the game.
Get it to Rosensteel. Her spot's right there at the free throw line or at that elbow. Get it into her.
Well, they tried, but this one got kicked away. But it's going to remain down there for the Bayhawks. But Rosensteel is having a very, very good game, especially from under the paint. She's making layups. She's shooting good from the floor, too, getting a lot of two-point shots. So she's definitely been doing her job. You just need the rest of the team to do their job to get her the ball.
Like I said, she's definitely showed a full repertoire of what she can do. They've missed her.
Throw over, pass back to Edwards. Parrish long throw over, Luna. Over to Edwards, good passing game right now. And this one is just missed,
Megan
almost
Parrish.
Trying to make another three.
Oh, that would have been a huge three.
She has that nice lofty release. It looks like it's just going to sink in every time, but unfortunately not the case this time.
The boys basketball team looking to inspire the girls, trying to push them on.
Wide open three, and this one just bouncing away.
They're lucky she missed that. She was wide open for that one.
Yeah, exactly. Edwards looks to drive. Luna hanging on to it, thinking about a shot maybe, as she's been doing, but not passing it away.
You got to help out. You can't just throw cross-court passes. That was beautiful.
That was a nice throw there by Parrish. Parrish wide open, but she's going to drive. She loses this one.
Ooh,
that's a big steal right there.
She got a pocket pick by Van Bellen.
That is a big steal.
Van Bellen. Oh, she traveled.
Yep, big time
travel.
Definitely
right traveled.
There. I'm trying to take her winter break early with the travel.
Happy holiday season, everybody out there. Yep, Santa's coming. Hopefully he can deliver a Bayhawks win, an early Christmas present for the Bayhawks here today.
And we saw Van Bemlen almost with a big steal, but just not able to hang on to it and went out of bounds. So this one's going to stay in favor of BCC. Still a 10-point game right now.
Going to be aggressive on the offensive end. It's going to be Megan time.
Been over.
Let's try to get inside. Nice defensive play by Jackson.
Contractor was not expecting a pass right there.
I think she was. She just couldn't do anything with it.
I don't know. It kind of looked like her reaction time was pretty late.
That being said, it was a good play by Jackson to knock it away.
Yep. This one just was still wide open shot.
Not the best shot by Jackson there, although she has the ability to hit that shot.
Yep. Bears out to Luna. Luna wide open the corner, shooting for three,
oh,
and it's good.
It.
The Bayhawks men love it.
That
was Katja Luna right there. She loves that shot, and she loves it more when she makes it.
I think it's the loudest I've ever heard this gym with the Roddy men's team over there. And the Knights turn the ball over.
And that
a lot
is
of time left in this one.
5:36 left, only down by 7 points right now.
BCC men's team trying to give the women's team a lift with a little home court advantage.
Well, we've seen the men's team play very good basketball now. Maybe they're trying to transfer some energy over to them. You know, Lady Bayhawks just got to get through this. And they can definitely do it right now with the way they've been playing.
Lady Bayhawks better return the favor when the men's team plays Saturday.
Well, they both will be playing, but the travel back now to Megan Parrish. She cannot be happy about that.
Travel there, but I guess she took one too many steps out there on the open court.
Maybe. Demlin over to Jackson. Jackson going up with it. Looked like she was going to pass back to Hands, but she shot it instead. It's Deborah Banks gets the rebound. Edwards driving down now. Rosa Steele calling for the ball. She's not
going
to get it. Parrish
going
up for two and just throws it away.
Ooh, I thought that might have went off Jackson or one of the Knights players.
But either way, they're calling it for Rhode Island. So Rhode Island catches a break now with 5 minutes left. Yeah, that could have been a huge play right there. This one not for Mr. Two. Edwards going down with it now.
Jackson has gone cold for the Knights. Now Nellen missed a shot there.
Edwards for three, but missing off. Deborah Banks gets the rebound. She's going to bank it, but it missed.
Oh, goodness, she put it too hard.
No.
Catch the ball. Get your whereabouts, your wherewithals, and put that up off softly off the glass. Don't be too nervous. Don't be too quick to put that shot up.
Exactly. In a game now that this is this close, the time winding down, you got to make your shots.
Yeah, get your bearings.
You know, pick your spots, make your shots. Rosa Steele has this one. And see what the call is.
Nice hustle, a nice fight there by Rosensteel.
And this one's going down, BCC's ball.
That's it.
And that is big right there. Again, Rosensteel playing a big game.
7-point lead, you're right there. Gotta love the effort. You gotta love the effort if you're Coach Aaron Morrell.
Yeah, this is looking like a completely different Bayhawks team than we saw last time. So much heart, so much hustle from these ladies.
Definitely, and talking, like I said, talking to Coach Aaron Morrell, a few girls that star of the year are not here anymore. You know, sometimes you got to get rid of the bad eggs in the room. Whether they're bad eggs or not sure the whole story, but nonetheless, they are down to six players. A team that started off with at least 10, 11 players is down to six. You know, but nonetheless, you got to love the effort.
Yep.
And that's all you can ask.
Yeah, exactly, but they've been definitely showing a lot better. What's the old saying? One bad egg ruins the bundle, something like that.
That can ruin the locker room. That can cause a lot of division. It can cause a lot of infighting, or whatever the case may be. Just a bad aura. You know, addition by subtraction is what they say.
Yep.
But anyways, down seven. Lots of time left here. You get a couple baskets, you're within three. It's not an insurmountable lead. They just got to, you know, opportunities are precious right now. You get an offensive rebound, take the time to see where you're at on the court, see where the defender is. If you need to do an up fake, if you need to take the ball one step closer to the hoop and put it out the glass, do it. You don't need to just, you know, be reactionary and then shoot the ball as soon as you get it.
Yeah, and the Lady Bayhawks, they definitely seem to be in this game a lot better mentally. The mentality of the game is very important. If you're not in it mentally, you're not going to be in it physically.
You're exactly right, and I go to what the Patriots say. I go to what Tom Brady always preaches, the winningest quarterback in NFL history.
Just got his 201st win.
Tom Brady always preaches about mental toughness.
You know what Tom Brady says? His favorite ring is the next one. Bayhawks definitely want to win one this year.
That's right.
Rosenstiel, a nice job getting it to Luna.
Luna doesn't have numbers. You got to kick it back out here.
Yep. So now Parrish, long throw over to Edwards. Edwards driving. She's popping it for two. Just not enough.
Bayhawks Hernandez going cold here. Not the time to go cold. Both teams going cold.
We haven't seen the Knights score in seemingly forever. With 3:25 left, down by six now. Edwards looking
She gets the foul. She definitely was fouled. Definitely contact there. Where's the ref at?
No call on that one. You could hear the men screaming from the bench, and one doesn't even get a foul shot.
That's for sure.
Jackson up for three. Missing Parrish with the easy rebound.
She has not made a shot in this quarter.
No, it looks like the Knights left their offense in the freezer. Everyone's going cold now. Nice pass back over to Parrish. Over to Edwards. Edwards popping a three. Line drive just missing.
Man. BCC has had every opportunity in the world to make this lead, make the Knights' lead even smaller, and they haven't had been able to do so because the Knights have gone cold as well.
Now 2.5 left now.
They're going to call a foul on Banks. On the interior on the foul, it's going to be a foul on Banks. That's her third. It's going to be Contractor. Contractor coming in for Banks. Had an opportunity to talk to the girls' team out in the hallway during the men's game, during the halftime of the men's game last week, Craig. And I said Banks and Contractor were like sisters. They both didn't like that very much.
It looks like Van Bemlen tried to take a seat wanting to watch this game. It has been quite an entertaining game.
It has. Still not over yet. 65-58. You got to make some baskets. You got to get. This is a huge possession here.
The Bayhawks are getting breaks. They're just not making shots. And Parrish looking to change that. She trips over herself. Luna putting up for three, and
that one
is good. She enters the splash zone with that one. 2 minutes remaining now, and it is a four-point game.
That changes the whole complexion of this game, Craig. Now it's down, like you said, two-possession game.
You can see everyone getting this game now. Edwards has it. Fast break over to Rosenstiel. Popped up. Looking to save it. She has it. Passes it back.
Horrible pass by Edwards. Horrible pass. Yep. Horrible.
Going over hands. Big pass back. Going to drive it. This one's for two.
Goodness gracious. Still two-possession game. Now, Misa Edwards, you know, you're down four. You got basically two safeties back there to use football terminology, and you throw it right to the defense.
Well, that one's tipped, but not in.
Oh, that would have been a huge hoop. Luna couldn't get it to go on that end.
Now with 1:10 left, down by six. Knights now just kind of looking to run out the clock. That's a big steal by Megan Parrish. She's going in, throws the body. She gets the foul.
God, that would have been so huge if she made that. She would have had the opportunity to cut this to a one-possession game, but she'll go the line though.
Yep, she can make this a four-point game right now. She can sink both of these. Under a minute now left.
Men's team getting rowdy out there. You're almost thinking, are they making the girls nervous? Are they making the girls do things that maybe they wouldn't do? I don't know.
She's able to sink the first one. Now it's down to five with 59.8.
Time is against him right now, but
she gets the second one. That is big.
Cuts it to within four. Need a big defensive stop here.
Yeah, you need something quick.
Now, I wonder if you're Coach Amarell, do you tell your team to foul here and force them to make free throws?
I think so, because they've been inconsistent, have been the Knights. Jackson going for it. Oh, and they're
call
calling the foul on Luna. Luna does not like that call at all.
The shot, the foul is going to be on the floor, though. So no free throws.
No basket.
And there's going to be a timeout on the court, seemingly by the Knights. So again, with 45.7 seconds left here, Craig, if you're Coach Amarillo, you're in an interesting position because do you foul early and lengthen the game and force the Lady Knights to make their free throws? Hopefully maybe they miss, and then you have extra possessions if you're BCC. Or do you sit back now because you've got 30 seconds on the shot clock? Do you try to – you got a foul now. It's a two-possession game. I think you get a foul early. Make them hit their free throws.
Definitely got to have them foul. The Knights have been very inconsistent with their free throws, so if you can force them, especially under pressure, then they have a better chance of missing it. You can get a fast break and score.
Yeah.
45 left, got to get 5 points to win.
But still, both teams only have three team fouls.
Right, they need now is just
two,
a big steal.
You need to get fouls. You need it. You got a foul to give right now. You got a foul. You got a foul if you're BCC. 23 on the shot clock.
Very
you got a foul.
Right now. She's letting her go, letting her drive.
Bad.
That one's in.
Totally bad.
Now it's a six-point game, 33.7 left.
If you're Coach Amarillo, you got to tell your team to foul there.
Yeah, you need a bit. They need a big shot right now. Contractor up.
Wow.
She gets the and one.
Holy bleep.
4 points left. Contractor have a chance to make it three.
Gotta love the effort. Bayhawks, you could cut it to three. This will be the closest they've been all evening.
Oh, man, my blood pressure is going up just by watching this.
Don't worry, you get a Navy medic here. Off the glass!
Off the glass in. They're calling something.
And they wave it off because Mr. Edwards with a lane violation. That's tough.
Oh, that is huge right there.
That's tough.
She's mad. The coach is mad. Everybody's mad.
You got a foul. You got a foul.
20 seconds left.
You have to foul. What are you doing?
God, what a
you
tough break.
You have to foul. What are you doing?
They're just going to hang on with it. 10 seconds left. Just passing around.
You have to foul.
It
what are
look
you
like
doing?
3, 2, 1, and that is the game.
What are you doing?
Just
what
an absolute,
in the hell just happened?
Just an absolutely horrible last break right there
what
for the Bayhawks.
What a horrible last 30 seconds.
Chance to make it a three-point game. Three-pointer to tie it, send it in overtime. That is just...
You just let them run the last 25 seconds off the clock and didn't even give yourself a chance to do anything there. I'm flabbergasted.
That's just disappointing right there. They're definitely probably going to get a talking to from their coach after this game.
Well, I think it was a big gap there. So 69-65, obviously a great effort here by the Lady Bayhawks, Craig. So we're going to wrap it up. You want to give our Lady Bayhawks player of the game, probably Shannon Rosensteel.
Yeah, definitely Shannon Rosensteel. She was able to do it all from scoring points to getting rebounds, making good shots, just doing it all. So the final score, 69-65 in favor of the Community College of Rhode Island Warriors. For Bayhawks basketball and FR Media, I'm Craig Salvador. And for Dave Cardoza, wish you a good night, and we'll see you on Saturday.
Good night, everybody.